Let's have a look at the latest features in the new Infinity Battlescape build. We now have in-game menus, like this comms menu, that lets us broadcast audio commands. Previously hitting the escape key closed the game, in the new version it opens the game's main menu. Here we have the option to purchase better ships with our in-game credits. We also can quit the game or eject and respawn in the ship we have spent credits on. The next new menu is the systems menu. In this menu we can activate the warp drive, toggle flight assist features, activate our front lights, power on our ship, and activate weapons, shields and engine overcharging. Another new menu is the weapons menu. In this menu we can toggle primary and secondary fire and also toggle autopilot features such as match speed to the selected target or orbit the selected target. This is also the first time that a leaderboard is included. Right now we can choose to belong to the red, green or blue team when launching the game. Another long awaited feature is the ability to freely move the outside camera around the ship. Your voice commands are also written into the comms window. You can also use the chat window by pressing enter and writing your own text. This patch introduces a new control mode. The old control scheme is now called direct control. In direct control, your mouse moves the crosshairs directly. The new mode is called Control Scheme Target. Your mouse now moves a separate cursor. The crosshair now follows this cursor. The new mode is much better suited to control larger and slower ships because you don't have to move the mouse constantly to perform longer turns. Currently, we can select between 6 different ships. The fast and free Interceptor, the Bomber, the Corvette, the Destroyer, the Cruiser, and the Carrier. The first version of bobbleheads are now included. The current solar system is made up of 6 planetary bodies. The Mars-like moon Erestia, the volcanic moon Cinder, the Earth-like moon Zarake, the ice moon Xemnos, the asteroid Galia, and the planet they orbit, the gas giant Rhesi Prime. The stations now look much better than before. They are now fully textured. Various lights and small details are now visible. For every killed enemy, we can earn a set amount of credits. These credits are permanent and remain in your account even when logging off. A single kill of the smallest ship, the Interceptor, transfers 400 credits into your account. Right now, 5 of these kills are necessary to earn enough credits to buy the biggest ship. This might of course change when gameplay balancing is done in the future. NPCs with a basic AI are now found in and around stations. These NPCs are included for testing purposes. It is possible that the final game won't feature AI enemies.